If you are trying to find a pair of safe solar eclipse glasses but can't seem to do so, that's all right. You can make yours from home.
Meteorologist Dylan Hedler shows us how to turn some common household items into solar eclipse projectors.
Let's make a DIY solar eclipse glasses. You're going to need just a few things: a cereal box, glue stick, scissors, Sharpie, some white cardboard paper or printer paper, and tinfoil. Just a few simple ingredients here. You start off with the cereal box. Open it up from the top, take the cereal out of it. You don't need that. Next thing we're going to do is take our white paper, lay it down flat, set the bottom of the cereal box on top of it, take your Sharpie and trace around the bottom of the cereal box. This will give us an outline of what we need to cut away. So once that's traced, you can remove the box, grab your scissors, cut this rectangle out. Once you have your rectangle and that's cut out, grab your cereal box again. You've opened it up, you've taken the cereal out, you're gonna take this and put it down on the inside at the bottom of the box. This is gonna be your viewfinder. Close the top lid of the box. You're gonna take your scissors again and cut out two sections. So now you've basically got a bare top of the box with a little viewfinder here in the middle. On one of the sides, preferably the right side, you're gonna take that tinfoil and cover that hole. And you're gonna puncture just a small hole right in the middle of this tinfoil, just like a quick jab. And what you'll do when the eclipse happens is turn your back to the sun, point your tinfoil, your little hole, to the sun and look through it. And on that white piece of paper, you'll see the eclipse down inside.
There you have it. Dylan did a great job, as you know, kind of walking us through step by step, a little tutorial.
But all of this might not even be needed depending on the weather on Monday.
Yeah, it's something we need to watch pretty closely, because in terms of visibility, if you're planning to check out the solar eclipse, much of the U.S. could see some good cloud cover for much of the event, including that path of totality. Now, it's still unclear if a specific town or location will be covered in clouds, but it appears that the clearest view of the eclipse right now looks to be in New England. So at least 99% of the U.S. will at least get a chance to experience a partial eclipse. It just remains to be seen
how much of that we'll be able to see.
Now, you're trying to find the sun in the sky, not a star behind cloud cover. Right. So you'll be able to find it. It's just a matter of how thin the clouds will get from time to time. I'm still optimistic that we're going to probably have no worse than partly cloudy skies, but that could change. So we're going to talk about that here.
We're still several days out, so we'll just stick you on air and online to get updates.
We'll give you the latest right now. Let's take a look at the forecast over the next several days. And this is a kind of a lower resolution model, and we use these to get out farther in time. As we'll start with the weekend, you can see it's going to start out chilly on Saturday with temperatures in the 30s, warming up into the 50s. There's decent precipitation to the north, but it should stay to the north. Then a storm system begins to cross the nation. You can see it starts to build some cloud cover and some good rainfall coverage. This gets us into Monday morning, the day of the eclipse. And this is pretty close to the path of totality. You've got a chance for showers in the morning, some heavy cloud cover in the area too. Even here locally, we could be on the edge of this system, bringing in at least some decent cloud cover, but there should be some gaps from time to time, and then better rain chances evolve for later this week. As far as the timing, you've heard this before. We're going to go through this a lot the next few days. This is going to occur Monday afternoon. The eclipse begins, the partial eclipse that we'll see here locally, just before 2 p.m. on Monday. The eclipse is expected to reach its maximum coverage of the moon over the sun. About 85% of the sun's light should be obscured. That occurs somewhere between 3:10 and 3:15. It really depends on where you live to get you the exact timing of totality. But right around that time, you should notice a difference 5 minutes apart. The eclipse will end as the moon begins to pull away from the sun. That should end during the 4 o'clock hour, and the sun will be shining brightly again, if it's not cloudy, just before 4:30. So our forecast actually warms things up again after a cool weekend. We'll have temperatures near 70. Right now I'm going with partly cloudy conditions. It's perhaps some optimism here, but that could change. So make sure you stay with us through the weekend.